Hi, everyone. Merry Christmas. Don Taylor here. This is Connected. Well, it turns out the close of the Mayan calendar, December 21st, didn't mark the end of the world. But hold on. Just in case you thought the Mayans got it wrong, what they were really talking about, what they were really forecasting all those years ago, was the end of the NHL Players Association. On Friday, we learned the NHLPA voted by an overwhelming margin to dissolve their union in a week and a half. The vote was 706-22 and gives the NHLPA's leaders the authority to file a disclaimer of interest and dissolve the union before January 2nd. It means we're another step closer to a scenario where individual players could file antitrust lawsuits against the owners. If successful, teams would be liable to pay players triple their lost wages and damages. We get more from Jeff Merrick and the panel.
Pretty quiet week around the NHL and the Players Association. No meetings, but there was news on Friday. The players voting overwhelmingly, Nick Kyprios and PK Subban, in favor of disclaimer of interest that would allow the union to walk away from the Players Association. As a member of the PA, this doesn't catch you as a surprise by any stretch, does it, PK?
I don't think so. I mean, talking to the players, you know, in the room and obviously at the charity game and just kind of hearing the overall reaction from the players once we knew that we were going to vote, you kind of expected, you know, that it was going to be overwhelmingly in favor. So, I mean, at this point, all this does, though, is give Donald Fehr our support in whatever direction he wants to take it, if he wants to go down that road or not. So I think that as a player right now, if someone would have told me back in September, hey, PK, by Christmas time, you guys are still going to be as tight as you guys are right now, a lot of people wouldn't believe that.
Clearly, you guys are on board here. And now, what does the league do with this? Obviously, there's an expiration date on your ability to vote for this, and that's January 2nd. Are we going to have meaningful negotiations before that? I really believe that they could get together as early as this weekend, just before Christmas, if that's what they really want. If not, then the league will sit on that January 2nd date where it expires and wait to see what your next move in. I really believe, guys, that the PA, if you come this far with the disclaimer of interest, you have to go all the way. The league has also threatened that that would end the season right away.
Do you believe that?
No, well, did we believe it when they said it in the NFL and the NBA, and the players still did it, and they still found a way to get a deal? So to answer your question, no, I don't believe it.
Is that how the dominoes fall? I mean, there's no meetings planned this weekend. We don't expect them to meet until sometime after the Christmas break. Is that how the dominoes fall on this one, Nick?
No, I don't believe that for a second. I think now we're at such a critical stage that there's so many people outside of Gary Bettman and Donald Fehr that will push for other meaningful negotiations, and I believe it'll happen before January 2nd. I'd really like to see what they did, three plus weeks ago, with a few owners in the room, players in the room. That's when we've made the most headway. We got to do it again.
You're at a very, and you anchored a very high-profile charity game in Toronto on Wednesday. Talked to a lot of NHL players that day, clearly. Where are they at right now? What's their mood heading into Christmas?
Well players want to play. It's been that way from the start, and you know, Donald Fehr has said it before, that the players aren't on strike. We're not on strike. We didn't choose to be locked out. You know, so we want to play hockey, and obviously, you know, skating every week with the guys is fun, and playing shinny is fun, but it's maybe fun for the first month.
You were -9 in that game. Are you sure you really want to play?
I want to play, and the guys want to play. You know, at this point now, it's getting around that time where it's close to crunch time, and guys want to see things happen.
-9. Who keeps plus-minus stats in a charity hockey game? That's harsh. That's the story from day 97 of the NHL lockout.